Hello everybody, Ice Dokie here, and welcome to another episode of my Let's Play of the Complete Yogcast Pack. As you can see, where the arrow is pointing, I have actually started laying out paths, because one of the requirements of the Iron Age tier is that you have paths linking the Town Hall to the Mining District and all the buildings in the Mining District, and also from the farm district to all of the buildings in the farm district and to the town hall and to the market district. So a couple of different things. You can see I've got all of the paths done here, which is pretty easy, pretty straightforward. I am going to be needing to repair some of these tools soon, so may as well find out now what it takes. Another question that I have is, can I throw that in? Does that heat up? No. What about you? Nope, what about you? Nope, see that? I don't particularly think any of these pieces of armor are all that useful to me. So I'm just going to get rid of them because my inventory is full. So, to the tool forge. Let's see. Let's go with the shovel. Yeah, see, that's pretty good. That didn't take a lot of iron to repair quite a lot of durability that I've used doing. Let's be honest, just digging. You can go back there, so I don't have to carry you with me. Got another head. Heads are pretty cool, but I really don't need that many heads. Some more flesh. Don't think anything good will come out. That's cool. I think that means I can just like throw things in and it'll work. Not exactly what I was after. The downside is I've now pretty much run out of gravel. So I'm thinking the best way to get gravel is to steal it from somewhere. And I think the village has quite a lot of gravel paths. Yeah, I'm not above stealing gravel. Must be a cave or something around there because the chews are going crazy. So yeah, hopefully there is some gravel here. Excellent, look at that. There is a huge amount of gravel. So I will steal all of it. Now, a trade. So I thought the thing was called like a... I thought it was called like a trade depot or something like that. Oh, never mind. So there's a lot of gravel here. And I'm thinking I'm going to come back and get all of it at a later stage. For now, anyway, I wanted to have a quick look. Just have a quick look around. See if there's anything that caught my attention. A little bit of iron. What the heck was that? An egg? There's a bit of a cave down there. Some nice looking marble. What are you? You are a big tree. Let's not mess with the big tree. So, other than my inventory being completely stacked up with useless things, which I now need to get rid of, that's what I was going to do. Hopefully, I can make it with these. So, what we want is we want a barrel, but not an ex nihilo barrel. We want a factorization type barrel. So, what is the recipe for them? Okay. Hopefully, this will work. Oh god, it's a pink barrel. I honestly didn't think that it was going to come out pink. Otherwise, I probably would not have done it. But with one pink barrel... Oh, they do stack. Yeah, that struck me as slightly odd that they didn't stack. I realized after doing it that I didn't actually use my carpenter's blocks to do anything nice with this place here. I also realize I now have the ability to make iron, so I can build the carpenter's hammer and pretty up how those doors look. But first I thought I would come down here. Um, Get rid of a bit of that amber bearing stone. Really? Come on. There we go. And throw another one there. And this is going to be okay. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing anymore. I thought I knew. Inventory tweaks will do its thing. Apparently no, it won't. There we go. So all of our dirt is now going to go in that barrel. And when I have a surplus of it, I'm going to throw cobblestone in that barrel. So I need more torches because I'm always running out of torches. Could probably do with some pressure plates there too. All these things that I'll get to eventually. But you may have noticed, or you may not, that I have an awful lot of animals. And some of them are wearing cool hats. But also my chickens were causing me problems, and I had too many cows. My chickens are still causing me problems. But I figured the thing that I would do this episode is build something that's just a little bit better way of kind of hanging on to those animals. Hold on. Where in the heck did my lumber axe go? Hello? This is super not cool. Like, no, seriously not cool. How do you lose a lumber axe? Hello? Did I put it in my... Did I put it over here? This is ever so slightly disturbing now. Because that was my good axe. Kind of misclicked, can I? I can indeed have misclicked. To be fair, could be worse. I could have done something quite seriously wrong. I want to find out what these do as well. Really, totally, apparently left my wood. See, what I'm going to do is, off camera, I'm going to quickly harvest my tree farm. And once that's finished, I'm going to make up a bunch of tinkerer's blocks. I haven't really got a better thing to call them, so I'm going to make up some tinkerer's blocks. And then I'm going to get working on the creation of what should hopefully be a really good farm. Hopefully. How'd you get out? So yeah, so I will see you guys in the very dear... the very near future. See you soon. Just quickly, guys, I thought I would let you in on a little secret. More than the 40 trees I'm required to have for my tree farm. So yeah, required to have a mine shaft at least 40 blocks deep. Pretty sure I covered that. And a tree farm that is at least 40 trees. So that's 70-something oak trees, plus a bunch of birch. So definitely got that covered. I thought while I was here, I would add a nice fence too. So again, these eucalyptus I don't really like, but it's okay because I can make torches, lots of torches. You could probably even go so far as to say that there was too many torches. Yeah, there is such a thing as too many torches. And I am probably pretty close to hitting it. But what I will do is just, you know, light this place up a bit. Particularly where these trees are. Don't like putting torches too close to birch saplings because I'm pretty sure it stops them from growing the way that they should. Again, not completely sure. Feeling kind of fairly confident though about lighting this place up. Yeah, what's the worst that can happen? What does F7 say? F7 says we are good. So I'm going to run with that and pretend that we're good. So over to my planks. You can see I got a lot, like a serious lot. So I'm not entirely sure exactly how I'm going to do this. I'm going to stick with the pink theme though for the fences. What I plan to do, I'm going to extend this out some way and kind of. I thought I had magnet mode on. What I'm going to intend to do is do something a little different for the chickens because they keep getting stuck in the corners here. But basically, I'm going to build a bit of a barn in the middle so that the animals have a place they can come into. And I'm going to do something. The other thing that I want to look up. Apparently, there's a muffle block. A sound muffle, that's what I'm looking for. Requires a note block, which requires redstone. Just for my own convenience, I might do that later. Oh, lumber. I was going to say, where the heck did my lumber axe go again? This is something I do want to test, because I'm pretty sure these giant trees. Yeah, look at that. Cop that giant tree. Give me your apple. So yeah, you can absolutely knock a giant tree down with one chop of a lumber axe. That, in my mind, makes it cool. Totally worth every cent I spent on it, just to have the ability to knock that thing down so quickly. So what I'm going to do is extend this farm outwards and make it big. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Why not 9? Let's go there. It's not going to be the world's biggest barn, but I do want to have an area where I can like store hay. So like a bit of a hay loft. See, I want to have a hay loft, and I want to have a couple of other little things that are going to help. No, stop. Get away from the gate. You. Let that be a lesson to the rest of you. Don't try to get out. But once I chop this down with my other axe, because I'm concerned that that one would cause bad things to happen. Once I've got the pens all sorted out, I'm going to bottle these creatures up and put them where they're supposed to be. Didn't mean to kill that chicken. So this is going to be roughly the pen size. I'm going to divide it up into half. And you know what? Because I think it will look cool, I'm going to do up a chicken coop to keep the chickens from getting stuck in things and being excessively chicken-like. How are we doing for spawning? Yep. So I'm going to do the same thing now with the pigs. And the sheep. Gonna. Accidentally kill some of them. Because, why not? Get out of the way. You're not helping. Man, I killed a sheep. Should not ever have to kill a sheep. Now that is still a pretty hectic farm. But if I leave the pen to be, say, maybe 4 or 5 blocks deep, plus a bit inside, how many blocks have I got to go? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, get out of the way. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 if I count that M bit. I think I did. Yeah, 18. So that means if I do it two block down the middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One, two, stop it. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What'd that give me? Did I count that badly? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, guys. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. I like your hat. 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks in the middle. That's what I want. Get out of the way. Why you gotta be like that, animals? What don't I need? String. Okay. Get out of the way. Nobody is listening to me. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Okay. I'm sorry. I didn't want to kill you, but you left me little choice. Get out of the way. Okay. Fine. Now, gotta divide these in half. Thankfully, I kept that little thing that let me know where halfway was. Get out of the way. I can't believe how much I'm having to say get out of the way at the moment. It's like they don't know that I'm not afraid to kill them. You know, pigs, you're only good to me as bacon. Okay, so what I'm going to do is then have a wall that probably runs through somewhere about here, and then a door for each pen, so there's a bit of an inside area, there's a bit of an outside area, and then a bit of a covered area in the center here. Not entirely sure how I'm going to do it yet. I am going to make it pink though, because eucalyptus wood is really easy to get. And then, once that's done, I will come back and we'll see how things look. So, until then, see you soon. Okay, guys, I'm back, and here is my big pink barn. Probably needs a little bit more texture on this side. I was thinking of maybe moving this wall in one, but for now anyway, that is a giant pink barn. So, come in here, you got one pen enclosed, two pens, three pens, four pens. I haven't finished enclosing this one yet, because there were just too many... ran out of wood. It's not so much that I ran out of wood as I put my wood away, because I forgot I was going to need it. What we have now is we have quite a low ceiling loft. I've been putting all my farm products in there. Lots of eggs, as you can see. Get to get in there. I do have to sort all my animals out because they're all in the wrong spots. But for now, anyway, not too bad a barn, I think. You can see there's a few animals that have escaped. Quite a lot, in fact, because I just didn't care. I killed a lot of them as well. I'll be honest with you though, most of the ones that died actually deserved it, because they were totally getting in my way. Like that, get out of the way, sheep. Get out of the way, piggy. Come on, get out of the way. It's amazing just how much these animals can get in the way. Okay, there we go. So one torch there and a torch there. Now we just need to dig out this last little bit over this side. And we're now pretty much good. Now I just need to sort the animals out so they're all in the correct locations. To be honest, don't need a gate there anymore. Is there another gate? Face. That was not meant to happen. See, this pen here's been pretty quiet. No gate there. It's good. What are we looking at over this side? Yeah, I really did cull through a lot of my animals. All unintentionally, of course, except when they got in my way. Like I said already, then they deserved it. Yeah, but that is pretty much my barn. It's not a huge paddock outside for the animals. But basically, in between this episode, which is going to be a bit of a shorter one, not too worried about that. In between this episode and the next one, I'm going to do some more mining off camera, because I want a lot more gravel. So like I said, so I can finish these paths. Yeah, I got this far, but really there still is quite a fair bit of work, and that's just to link it up with these couple of buildings here. What I'm trying to do is keep to the natural elevation of the terrain as well. So if I take my remaining 6 gravel, it would be like that, and then a bit of a step down. So yeah, trying to stick to the natural lay of things. Trying to make it at least remotely interesting. You know, I don't want everything to be dead flat, because nowhere in the real world is dead flat. So yeah, I need a lot more gravel, because I've got a whole lot of those to make my pink barn. And so I've replanted them all, and they grow really fast. Massive tree farm that's grown over that side. But yeah, so now I need cows, pigs, sheep, and chickens. And yeah, I was considering making a proper chicken coop. Too hard. Can't be bothered. Would add no value anyway. But what I probably can do that might add some value is... why did I only get... Wow. That's pretty bad on a seed farm. Wonder if I can get myself some hay bales. At least that way my loft will look like it's got something in it. I do like your hat. You're a pretty cool little guy. We got 44. At least that's 4 bales of wheat. Make it at least look a little bit like it's a hayloft. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Wow. Totally set up for the future. So yeah, until next time, thank you very much for watching. Like I said, sorry this is a bit of a shorter episode. But that actually took quite a bit of building off camera. I have used these ones here, the carpenter's wedges. So you've seen me make the carpenter's blocks, so I use the carpenter's wedges, which are 3 of those and some sticks, and then you basically just put planks on them and it colours them. And you get a pretty cool effect, actually. You can make some really nice brick roofs with that. So yeah, pretty nice looking, I think. I was thinking of putting like half slabs along there to make it just a narrow sort of like a slat opening. But again, time just kind of got the better of me. And I don't want to make this boring for you guys, or for myself, actually, so... Yeah, I'm just trying to keep things interesting, keep things moving along. Next episode, I think I'm going to do some work on the market district, just kind of lay out where things are going to be. Market. So I need a marketplace that has a licensing office, with a lobby and 2 offices, and a different room for storage, and a flag out the front, so that's going to need some wall and some dye. Then I need some community structures, some dwellings, and a marketplace with a bunch of stalls and things like that. So quite a lot that I need to do in the marketplace. So probably the sooner I get started, the better, I think, with that. So yeah, until then, thank you very much for watching. Astocky out.